Most people have heard of Pictures Up, but did you know the movie was inspired by real-world events? It turns out, real people go to crazy lengths to avoid moving out of their homes, from mid-apple abodes to majestic nail houses. Let's explore the world's most stubborn homeowners who refused to move out. Number 10. Edith Macefield. Edith Macefield became a folk hero in 2006 when she turned down a $1 million offer for her little Seattle farmhouse. The planned five-story commercial development continued regardless, but had to awkwardly build around Macefield's 108-year-old house. She remained there until her death in 2008, aged 86. In her will, she left the house to the new building's construction superintendent, who had incidentally become a personal friend and caretaker to her. In 2009, Disney publicists tied balloons to the roof of Edith's house as promotion for the movie Up. It's even rumored that Edith's story was the inspiration for the film. Number 9. Huff House. In 1957, Windlass Holdings started to buy up all the property in St. Patrick Street, Toronto. Their takeover plan was going smoothly until they ran into house number 54 and half. Visually, it was already named number 54 and half before it actually became half a house. Half of the duplex sold, but the other half refused. So, the developers very carefully tore down half of the building, leaving the load-bearing divider wall intact. It's remained in this strange state ever since and is currently occupied. Number 8. Nail houses. Stubborn homeowners have become something of a phenomenon in China. The abodes of these homeowners are known as nail houses because the owners remain stuck in a place like hammered in nails. In some cases, after the surrounding architecture has been torn down, the buildings even resemble nails. The Chinese government has considerable trouble getting rid of these people who refuse to move regardless of how much money they are offered. In retaliation, the government plays dirty by cutting power lines and even digging moats around some houses. That's pretty medieval. Number 7. Airport farming. Narita Airport, Tokyo's main international airport, had a controversial opening in 1978 when it was built despite protests from nearby farmers. It had to operate with just one runway until 2002 due to legal problems stopping them from constructing more. Eventually, they managed to buy most of the surrounding farms and expand. But farmer Takao Shito had no interest in moving. As a bitter compromise, the route leading to the runway was built to curve around Shito's farm, which is right in the middle of the airport. The 68-year-old accesses the farm by underground tunnels. Number 6. Roadhouse. This house in Shanghai stood proud for over 10 years after plans to build a road were announced. The family of seven living there didn't think that the government was offering them enough money to move, so they stayed put. Naturally, the road was built around them. The constant traffic was incredibly noisy and the front door was only 3 feet from the road. But it was home, I guess. Number 5. Sandwich House. Mary Cook bought her home in West Avenue, Manhattan when housing in the area was still affordable. When an influx of wealthy people triggered modern apartment blocks to start springing up on both sides of her house, Mary refused offers to move. So now, this little old New York townhouse remains there, stuck between these two huge apartment buildings, like Tom Cruise at a basketball game. Number 4. More stubborn, less stubborn. This house in Washington Heights, Manhattan, is a holdout from a different era, when Manhattan had detached and semi-detached houses on the streets. Instead of endless apartment buildings, it's survived into modern age thanks to its current use as a church. Worshipping in a creepy-looking place like this could actually be fun. Number 3. Neighborhood Black Sheep. In Suzhou, China, in July 2013, one lone homeowner refused to sell out to people hoping to revitalize their neighborhood with luxury apartments. Now, this old-looking house that once fit into its neighborhood so well stands out like a piece of history. Granted, a rather drab, gray history, but history nonetheless. Number 2. Cooking versus the world. Vera Cooking and her husband bought this New Jersey property in 1961 as a summertime retreat. Over the next 3 decades, they declined multiple offers to buy the house, leading Penthouse magazine owner Bob Guccione to start building his new hotel casino around their house. But when Guccione ran out of money in 1980, construction stopped. The house was surrounded by ugly scaffolding until 1993. When Donald Trump tried to buy the property from Cooking, he aimed to expand his nearby casino and hotel and build a parking lot for limos. But still, no dice. Under the influence of Trump's legal teams, the city attempted to condemn the house under eminent domain. But Cooking, stubborn as a mule, fought the government and won, continuing to live there until 2010. Number 1. Acres Abode. In 2011, Portland State University had managed to convince everyone on a local street to move out of their homes to make way for their new building project. Everyone, that is, except for Randall Acker. Randall had only recently bought and renovated his home and had no desire to leave. Unfortunately for the university, Randall was also a lawyer. He fought them every step of the way. Now, there's a quaint little house from the 1800s in the middle of this student residence area. Aware of his situation similarity to Pictures Up, like Edith Maxfield's case, Acker flew 400 balloons from his chimney to celebrate his victory in style. What kind of house would you hold out for as this stubborn homeowner did? Would you dare to spend the night in a Chinese snail house? Let me know in the comments section below.